two huge men about ready to collide here on Monday Night Raw.
Listen to the sound of this.
And here we go.
The WWE has seen some big, big wrestlers with super heavyweights such as Andre the Giant, Mark Henry, Yokozuna, and many more. As impressive as these big men are, it's even more impressive when they battle each other. Join us now as Wrestlelamia looks at the 13 greatest battles of the super heavyweights. Be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell for daily wrestling videos and follow us on Facebook for exclusive lists. Now the concept of two super heavyweights is firmly ingrained in our culture, whether it's giant monsters in movies battling each other like Godzilla vs. King Kong, Pacific Rim and numerous others, elephants battling each other for territorial supremacy, and here, larger-than-life wrestlers often battling for bragging rights to see who the dominant big man is. Well, let's start off with number one as we go all the way back to 1976 as two monsters clashed in the ring, Andre the Giant versus Ernie Ladd. Now, Andre the Giant's size and remarkable in-ring abilities quickly earned him the nickname the Eighth Wonder of the World. A promoter's dream, Andre toured the world as a special attraction, usually drawing big crowds. However, it could be difficult to find opponents who seemed a challenge to the big man, as there were few opponents even close to his height. One such opponent was Ernie the Cat Ladd, who stood nearly as tall as Andre and had perfected his act of a bullying, arrogant heel.
The only shot you're gonna get right in your mouth!
The two met in the Mecca of professional wrestling in 1976, battling in what looked to be an evenly matched encounter. However, Ladd wasn't looking for a fair fight and employed a foreign object to get the advantage, wearing Andre down with it. Ultimately, all Ladd did was anger the Giant and Andre snapped, pummeling his opponent senseless until he fled the ring. The referee counted Ladd out as Andre watched his opponent head for the locker room. These two would do battle all over the world, but it's difficult to imagine a bigger venue than the Garden. Number 2, Andre vs. Killer Khan. Now, injuries can sideline a wrestler, costing both wrestlers and promoters money. However, when Andre the Giant fell out of bed and broke his ankle, promoter Vince McMahon Sr. made lemonade out of lemons. Rather than giving the real story, the WWF announced that the monster-like Killer Khan had broken Andre's ankle during their 13th April 1981 match at the Rochester War Memorial Auditorium. On 4th May 1981, the WWF announced Andre's injury and played it up over the next few weeks on television, with Khan and his manager Classy Freddie Blassie claiming they'd taken Andre out. Andre returned in crutches and confronted Blassie, only to get blindsided by Khan. This led to a series of Mongolian stretcher matches, basically a glorified stretcher match where you incapacitate your opponent until they were carried to the back. Andre defeated Khan, getting revenge and the WWF cashing in on Andre's accident. Number 3, Hulk Hogan and Andre the Giant vs. Big John Studd and King Kong Bundy on Saturday night's main event. One of the most fearsome teams in WWE history was Big John Studd and King Kong Bundy. The team manager Bobby Heenan boasted they can't be slammed and can't be pinned, of course referring to Studd's claim he could be pinned and Bundy's boast he'd give opponents a 5 count to keep things fair. Regardless of hyperbole, Studd and Bundy crushed anyone who got in their way, and in Andre the Giant's case, Bundy crushed Andre's sternum in a storyline injury. Andre went through a number of tag team partners, but they proved incapable of the task. That is until he brought in his friend WWF champion Hulk Hogan. The team squared off on the 2nd November 1985 edition of Saturday Night's main event. While Andre and Hogan only got a DQ win, it was clear they were more than up for the task of going toe-to-toe with Bundy and Studd. Bundy wouldn't forget what happened though, as we're about to see next, as number 4, King Kong Bundy vs. Hulk Hogan. After the inaugural WrestleMania's tag team main event match, the WWF decided to put champion Hulk Hogan into a singles match at WrestleMania 2, this time pitting King Kong Bundy against him, and not just in any match, but in a steel cage match. The WWF had been building Bundy up as a monster heel, teaming him up with Big John Studd, but also having Bundy demolish opponents with his Atlantic City Avalanche. At 450 pounds, the man Gorilla Monsoon, nicknamed a walking condominium, set his sights on the Hulkster, laying him out in a vicious attack. Bundy delivered numerous splashes to Hogan, kayfabe injuring his ribs and making him a seemingly easy opponent for WrestleMania 2. With his bruised ribs taped up, the Hulkster faced a difficult battle in the cage, and things looked desperate when Hogan failed in his attempt to body slam Bundy, with the big man falling on top of him. Bundy delivered an Atlantic City Avalanche and Big Splash, but Hogan rallied, hulking up and no-selling another avalanche. Hogan found the strength to body slam Bundy, hitting the leg drop and climbing out the cage. Number 5. Hogan vs. Andre. It's difficult to choose a match between Hogan and Andre because both men had some extraordinary encounters. In terms of match quality, there's no denying that their match at the 1980s showdown at Shea was the best. But in terms of build-up, nothing compared to WrestleMania 3, the event that began after a bitter Andre joined forces with longtime nemesis Bobby the Brain Heenan to challenge Hogan for the championship.
I'm there for one reason, to challenge you for a world championship match in the WrestleMania.
Although Andre was broken down physically, the hype for the match was so good that the fans didn't even care, making WrestleMania 3 a smash success. Hogan carried Andre to a passable match, slamming the giant and pinning him as Andre passed the torch to the Hulkster. Number 6. Earthquake vs. Hulk Hogan. Hulk Hogan was a larger-than-life champion, which often made it difficult for fans to take opponents seriously unless they were monster heels. While there were exceptions like Macho Man Randy Savage and Paul Mr. Wonderful Orndorff, the WWF was always looking for the next super heavyweight for Hogan to slay. Enter Earthquake, aka John Tenta, the sumo-turned-pro wrestler who laid Hogan out on an episode of the Brother Love Show and seemingly ended Hogan's career. After losing to the Ultimate Warrior at WrestleMania 6, Hogan's injury only compounded his doubts whether he should continue wrestling. After Hogan's friend Tugboat encouraged Hulkamaniacs to send letters of encouragement to Hogan, rumor has it the WWF added those fans' addresses to their mailing list for hawking merchandise, Hogan returned to action facing Earthquake at 1990 SummerSlam. Earthquake gave as good as he got, with Hogan only managing to get a countout. The two would lock up over the next several months, including a traditional Survivor Series match at the 1990 event. Hogan also eliminated Earthquake as the last man in the 1991 Royal Rumble. The Hulkster finally ended the feud by defeating Quake in a series of stretcher matches. Number 7. The Undertaker vs. Yokozuna. Like Hulk Hogan, it was difficult to find credible opponents for The Undertaker to battle. In the case of Yokozuna, there was no doubt the big man posed a threat to Taker, as the WWF champion had turned back challenger after challenger, including Lex Luger, Crush, and Randy Macho Man Savage. At the 1994 Royal Rumble, Undertaker faced Yokozuna in a casket match, and while Yokozuna proved a fearsome foe, The Undertaker had gotten things going his way. But that is until a small army of heels beat him senseless, aiding Yokozuna in defeating him and seemingly killing off The Undertaker. But as we all know, The Undertaker returned. Number 8. Vader vs. Yokozuna. If you want to get a big man over, have another big man count the lights for him. When Vader entered the WWF, the promotion had him wrestle Yokozuna, who had just turned babyface. Vader broke Yokozuna's leg in a storyline that saw the sumo super heavyweight taken out on a forklift rather than a stretcher, just to show how much of a behemoth he was. The two would battle at In Your House, but regrettably, Yoko's weight had become an issue and what could have been a classic was knocked down a notch. Yoko put Vader over as fans wondered what things might have been like if Yoko was at the top of his game. Number 9. The Undertaker vs. The Big Show on Raw in 1999. The Big Show was another super heavyweight opponent that made the challenge of trying to defeat The Undertaker. Although these two titans would clash numerous times, one of their most memorable encounters occurred on the 7th June 1999 edition of Raw. After Taker attempted to jump off the top rope, The Big Show caught him, chokeslamming him through the ring, ingraining this spot in the fans' memories.
Oh, oh my God! Right in the ring!
Number 10. Brock Lesnar vs. The Big Show. This seemed like a match too big to contain in the ring, and this proved true during the 12th June 2003 episode of SmackDown. When Brock Lesnar went to superplex The Big Show, the fans and announcers were astonished, but not compared to what happened next, the two slamming down on the ring and causing it to implode.
What the hell?
It was one of the greatest spots in WWE history and too fantastic not to repeat, as we'll see next as number 11, The Big Show vs. Mark Henry at Vengeance 2011. Mark Henry was in the midst of a monster push in 2011, building up his reputation by taking out opponent after opponent. As we'll see, whenever the WWE wants to get someone over big, who else but to bring in but the Big Show? Regardless of how often he's counted the lights, a win over Show always seemed like it means something. At 2011's Vengeance pay-per-view, Big Show challenged Mark Henry for the World Heavyweight Championship in a battle of the Behemoths. The match was a power-packed profile and pummeling as each wrestler utilized their strength to try and take out the other. Despite the tremendous toll inflicted on each other, neither man would stay down. Finally, taking a page from 2003 SmackDown, Henry superplexed Show, causing the ring to implode and the match ending in a no contest. Number 12, The Big Show vs. Braun Strowman. Now, if we're going to get Braun Strowman over as a monster heel, what better by demolishing a big man? But who could we use? Oh, of course, The Big Show. On the 17th April 2017 Raw, the destructive duo clashed in an all-out brawl that saw The Big Show choose poorly by going to the top rope. Perhaps bad advice from Nature Boy Ric Flair. Moving with incredible speed, Strowman intercepted Show and superplexed him, and as you can probably guess, the ring imploded.
Oh my God! The ring just imploded!
This time, Strowman quickly got up, unlike the Big Show who laid motionless on the remains of the ring. Although fans had seen this spot more than once, it was still exciting and a great way to get Strowman over. At number 13, Braun Strowman vs. Brock Lesnar. While more than a few fans have questioned the WWE's decision to keep Braun Strowman from defeating Brock Lesnar for the Universal Championship during their matches, there's no denying the Monster Among Men proved to be one of the Beast Incarnate's best opponents during his second campaign in the WWE. Arguably, their best match was their clash at 2017 SummerSlam, where it was a fatal four-way between Strowman, Lesnar, Roman Reigns, and Samoa Joe. The 20-minute fight was a canvas of chaos as each wrestler beat each other to a pulp. As before, Strowman would come up short against Lesnar, but Roman Reigns would count the lights for him. But there you have it, guys, the 13 greatest battles of the super heavyweights. Which matches are your favorites? Let us know in the comments down below, subscribe if you haven't already, follow us on Instagram and Facebook for exclusive lists, and I'll see you next time with some more wrestling content.